Blended watercolour wash. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a blended wash for a blade of grass that blurs into the background behind a grasshopper that I've painted. Hi, my name is Paul Hopkinson and I'm a professional watercolour wildlife artist. I teach online on my website, have a look at the link down below, and also of course here on YouTube. Now for the grass, what we're going to do is work with a basic bog standard background wash first of all. But one thing I want to mention, is that when we've got this extra piece coming up the side there, now when you look at that reference photograph again, you'll notice that this particular blade goes all underneath there, and as I did mention at the beginning, it kind of branches out a little bit in the background, doesn't it? So what we need to do is just dampen this background down and drop some colour in. Now the colour we're using is going to be the Gambo Hue and Indigo, which is this one here. Okay, that's one here. And we're going to work with that for the basic wash first of all. But over the top of that, the Gambo Hue, Olive Green and Burnt Sienna. I think I'm going to add a little bit more Burnt Sienna into that one actually. Just to kind of dullen it a fraction. Something like that there. And we can just kind of intermingle that in. Just kind of drop a little bit of that in as well. We don't want the grass blades looking too bright green. It's more like a bluey green, isn't it? Like a bluey yellow. So that's what we're looking for, something like that. Alright, so now we've got that all sort of sussed out. When you're working on this blurry one, I'll just dampen a piece of test paper first, get that off there. Okay, so dampen it down. And what you want to do is let the water soak into the paper just a little bit. So when you've got that layer on, you want to get this, as I said, to more of a, there you go, to more of a kind of nearly not dry condition, but more or less kind of in between the two. So it's still a bit damp. And you see the texture of the paper in there, can't you, when you're looking at that? And that's what I'm looking for, that texture. So that's already just about there. Start off with the first colour mix of the Gambo Hue and Indigo. And you want it more on the blue side than the green side, really. You know, and then you drop that colour in. As simple as that. That's all you do, just drop the colour in. Then with a damp clean brush, just soften down that edge, that top edge, just to blend it out. You want to kind of blend it so it blends into the white of the paper. So you can't see where one colour starts and the other colour finishes. All right, that's a Bob Ross term, that one, by the way, if anybody knows Bob Ross. Something like that. We need it slimmer than this. This is just an example. And then in the background of that, just drop in some of the other colours you've got, which is this one here. So that's a Gambo Hue, Olive Green and Burnt Sienna. Just drop a little bit of that in there. Just to change it a fraction, just at the beginning of it. See the idea? But do this much smaller than I've got on there. And you see what I mean when I start working on the painting. Allow it to dry, by the way. And when that's nice and dry, you'll have a nice kind of blended out edge to that as well. If you do this when the paper's really, really soaking wet, the paint will just go everywhere. And when it goes everywhere, you can't control it as easy, can you? So allow the water to soak in, as I mentioned, just so it kind of just goes off a little bit, but you've still got a bit of a shine on it. Then add the colour in. I'm now going to show you how I would paint the grass blade in the foreground, which isn't blurry, so that you can clearly see the different techniques and the effects when I work on the blurry one afterwards. So the first thing you want to do is dampen it down. Now I want to go probably to about there where my pencil is, around that area there. And that's where it's going to just fade out to the white of the paper. That's all I want to do there. And I'm using a size 2 brush at the moment. And I want this to come down to probably here. And then this one carries on down here. Let's see where that goes. Because there's one in between as well, but I might not paint that one in. There's a little bit of a kind of stretch just there. Allow this to soak into the paper a little bit as well, just like I was just telling you about, really. So you can just see the texture of the paper. And you can see the water just going off a little bit. Grab some of that colour, so the Gambo Hue and Indigo, and drop that colour in to begin with. And this will soften, this will weaken as it dries as well. Go right to the very top, just on the edge of your pencil marks there, and then pop this in. How rich that is. So you can take some paint off the brush and just move that along. You can control this, you know you can. This whole grasshopper painting is available as a complete tutorial within my online school. And I'll pop a card to the top right if you're interested in finding out that little bit more about becoming a member.
Just want it nice and faint.
Now, I suggest you don't go back to the top area because you want that to stay kind of blended, don't you? So while that's on the paper on this side of the leg, let's grab the next colour, the one with the burnt sienna, and that gambo hue, olive green and burnt sienna. And we'll drop a little bit of that in. There's only a slight variation in colour, but it's enough. It's enough. Just along there. And then we'll carry on for the part of the grass blade below now. Okay. So back to the gambo hue and indigo, and we'll drop that one in. That'll do. We'll drop it in here. That'll do. And I'm going to just take a little bit of paint off the brush and move that around. Move it, move it.
Also, don't forget to click on that subscribe button down below, and don't forget that bell icon as well, just so you'll never miss one of my YouTube videos.
Okay, down to the edge. Try and keep the edge nice and neat. And that gap disappears, doesn't it? So you've got a bit of a gap, as I mentioned there. I might get a little bit more colour, actually. Just there, and it just disappears. Okay, and that goes down to there, where it goes underneath. We're going to get the next colour with a burnt sienna in. We'll drop that one in, just around here. So it kind of carries on from underneath there for that change of colour. It's not quite the same as a photograph, but we don't have to get it the same as a photo. Right, okay, let that dry, or give it a blast with a hairdryer, and we'll do the same with the second one as well. But notice that this is a little bit more bluer than this one. So you want to use the gambo hue and indigo, mostly for this particular blade of grass.
Now, we're going to move on to the blurry grass blade, and you'll see how I keep all the edges of this one wet, and I work with a damp brush around them to keep encouraging the paint to blend and diffuse.
I'm just wetting this area here, and it's wet enough, just about nearly there, for me to add on. We can just get the shine on there for you. See that shine there? So you can see how wet that is. I can just see the texture of the paper as well in there, which is what I'm looking for. So what I need to do now, just grab some of that first colour, you know the one, gambo hue and indigo. I'm going to drop this in right in the centre of this to begin with. Right in the very centre. Now, remember to keep your head tilted to one side. I know it looks a bit odd. If anybody saw you now, they'll be thinking, that person all right? But by doing so, at least then, you can see where the wet area is. And you can just control that water and where it goes. That colour especially. So I'm just adding this in to here for now. Okay, something like that. There's a little bit of yellow in that as well, so I'm just going to add some very watery gambo hue in there, just to change it a fraction. Wash that brush out. Okay, and I'm going to add some water again to the top of this area, keeping your head tilted to one side, and then soften that down so it just blends away into the background. And just tidy that up, and that's just about there. So that gives us a bit of a soft edge around the outside here as well. Because we don't want it too harsh, do we? We don't want it too hard an edge, because we want it to just kind of blend away. You can have a little bit of a change of colour around here, and that is the one with the burnt umber in. Just around there. Don't flood it too much with colour, because you find it could just try to spread again to those kind of outer damp areas, and you want to try and control those outer areas like here, for example. I want it to be blurry. Background and blend away. That'll do.
I hope you can see how using these two different techniques for two separate blades of grass brings a sense of depth and realism to the painting, with the furthest blade looking like it's further behind the grasshopper. If you'd like to see some of the grasshopper being painted, I have a section where I was using a new white paint, which you may find interesting. You can see the link to the top right. I'll see you there.